The factions in South America follow not out of faith, but out of fear. Fear alone won't be enough to bring the other factions into the fold. Leaders have arisen who command respect and undying loyalty. There is one in particular who plays lord over what is left of the Black Hand, a heretic. His name? Brother Marcion.
There was given to him a mouth speaking great lies and blasphemies, and his name was Kane.
He has a gift, an oratorical gift.
I bring light
to the lost and hope to the hopeless. I bring the promise of peace and the prophecy of the power of Tiberium.
His loyalty was unquestioned. And then GDI took advantage of his one weakness, his vanity. They convinced him that he was destined to be Nod's leader and that I was in fact a charlatan. One of Marcion's fanatics murdered my successor, Anton Slavik, leader of the Black Hand. Marcion then led his followers into the Australian outback. His support grew as he spread his false prophecy, creating an army of zealots, a new Black Hand.
His time is done. His legacy, a distant memory, for only I know the true path. Only us!
Since I cannot yet reveal myself, we will use this false prophet to lead the Black Hand back to the light. Find him. Capture him. Persuade him.
So here we go. That's some nice hovercrafts here. Stingray shape.
Marcion's path to correction begins today. We must make landfall in the heretic's territory. You must send a strike force across the oceans to Australia. Soon, my child. Soon.
New construction options.
Rise up!
Incoming
transmission. So here we are.
This lab contains the last existing record of the Brotherhood's stealth technology. Capture it.
Will do. But let me also get some engineers here, or saboteurs, for a very specific reason. Can we get two of these? Because we're going to need a lot of power here, because we only have the limited tech tree.
As the Brotherhood splintered in the aftermath of my death, our technology was left to rot, years of research left by the wayside. My spies have located an abandoned GDI laboratory where our stealth technology, captured long ago, sits idle, neither exploited nor understood by those narrow-minded fools. Reclaim it for the Brotherhood.
Will do, but first let me get some scorpions.
Building captured. Training.
So we're going to need those. Also mortar air. So there's a lot of spikes on this map. You want to capture those because you're going to need some decent income. And here we go. Let's get that here. Yeah, let's get those scorpion tanks. I'm building those for a reason. So you get in here, little saboteur. And now I have insufficient funds. But that's how things are. So, you stay here, and I hope I get at least two or three more scorpion tanks out before they attack. Then we should be good. And maybe one more power plant, because I don't want to risk running low on power. Yeah, as you can see...
Attention! Attention, you fanatical scum! Yeah, you didn't think you'd go undetected, did you? This is GDI. Steel talent territory. We don't take too kindly, you Nod types around here. You best get praying to that corpse prophet of yours, because you don't stand a chance in hell.
Unit under attack.
Oh, so here we go. Intelligence data updated. These are hammerheads. Hammerheads are essentially not choppers. Not choppers. They are choppers more similar to the Venoms, and they can. fire without needing to refill the ammunition. And look at that. So there's some Titans and Wolverines here. Those guys are essentially like the guys from Tiberian Sun. Like all steel Talon units, they are over-specialized. So the Wolverines are really only good against infantry, and the Titans are really only good against tanks. They are good against what they are, but they are still over-specialized. So let's quickly kill these guys here before they kill us. You guys should probably join the fight, because getting torn apart here. Yep, Tibua 2. That's what the cool kids call it these days. So that said and done, let's get a second refinery. Actually, let's get another harvester first. And yeah, here we go. You guys can stay here. Oh, that was just the repair drone. For some reason, I thought I was getting attacked here. Let's get that, and let's also get another refinery to exploit this Tiberium field here. Yeah, the Steel Talons, by the way, the guy who was playing the Steel Talon guy was Duncan Kincaid's brother, his younger brother, who also played Jake McNeil in Tiberian Sun. So that was him. And you probably want to say, oh yeah, the Steel Talons, they're probably the weakest factions, the weakest of the subfactions. But at the same time, there's still a good chance in this mission, especially because my tech tree is limited. And their units hit very heavy. Their units are heavy and hit hard, but they are over-specialized generally. The Wolverines are really only good against infantry. The Titans are really only good against tanks. So they lack a little bit of being all-roundedness, if you want to call it that, which is essentially what GI is best at. Let's maybe build one more of these and let's get another harvester, so we can have two harvesters on that field over here. That should give us some decent income. Let's also get maybe Shredder turrets here and there, just so we have something that can absorb damage while we bring in units in case that is actually necessary. So here we go. And let's actually get this quadrant upgrade, which is pretty good. Puts another turret on your hubs. So essentially increases the firepower by a third for all your base defenses. Pretty good deal, especially because it only costs 1,000 and it affects all the base defenses you have. So yeah, definitely recommend that. So I'm going to build more Scorpion tanks too, and put you guys, yeah, can't really build near the spikes anyway, so may as well put you guys here. The Scorpion's ready. And then we should be set up essentially. Yeah, these guys here, they have a base here, and there's also the laboratory here. We are going to need a good number of tanks to defend our base against what they throw at us. Even though we could probably also get some laser turrets here. Yeah. I might do that as well, just to be sure. And as you can see now, we've got these neat. There's new turrets here on the hubs. So more power. And more laser turrets. Here we go. And maybe one over here. I could also could send an emissary here and then build base defenses here and there. But I'm not quite sure whether that's actually worth it. Maybe not. Well, now I've built some here, so let's stick with that for now. Let's also get a second arms factory. And let's gather you guys over here. And let's get a couple more of you guys. Yeah, the laboratory isn't all that well defended. There's some guys around it, but it's not really... There's no real base, just some base defenses and some units. The base here is another story. It's going to take a lot of firepower to take it over, especially with the limited forces I have. And because they are going to send a lot of Titans and a lot of rocket guys. And the rocket guys are kind of hard to deal with. You can send radar buggies, but the problem is those radar buggies, they will get shred to pieces in absolutely no time. And you're probably better off by just rolling over whatever infantry they send you with even more scorpions. So That said, let's get yet another power plant. And let's get a secret shrine. I don't really think we need a secret shrine, but we may as well build it because it's not that expensive. And it does cost actually a considerable amount of power. So anyway, let's get an air tower as well. I'm not going to bother with venoms all that much, but because venoms, yeah, these slingshots the steel tanks have, the slingshot is their specialized anti-air unit. It's a hover tank. Can only shoot air units, but it's really good against them. That's going to kill everything I have that's flying, so I'm not going to bother with that. But while we're at it, may as well send these guys over here. And nope, that's not where you wait a second. We can't get through here. Nope, doesn't look like it, so I guess we have to go around. Because there's more spikes, more Tiberium spikes here, and there's going to be some defenses here as well, but I can clear those out with my tanks. Seems like the steel talons don't seem to be overly interested in actually attacking us. I'm pretty sure as long as you don't trigger them, they don't really do that. Oops. Yeah, this is a slingshot hover tank. Extremely good against anti-air, not really good against anything else. In fact, I can't even attack anything else, so yeah. There's that. I could establish a second base here. Well, look at that. A watchtower. And the second watchtower. But if I take those out, I can access all these spikes here, which is going to be pretty sweet. So that said, let's move north because there's two more here. And let's get my saboteurs over there as well as soon as they are ready. And let's build more of these guys. Let's get out there. So what else do they have here? Well, it's just static stuff, so not a problem. Let's just focus fire and get over here. And maybe put some mines here. Unfortunately, like all the powers, the mines aren't free, but hey, what can you do? So what? Oh, these guys. Did they got my attention? Maybe. Well, I'm certainly have theirs. So anyway, you get over here. And I think I'm going to guard you in the meantime. There's also a spike here, but if I get that spike taken over by a saboteur, I might actually attract their attention, and I don't really want that right now. So nope, that was the wrong point here. So what's the plan? You guys gather here. Where are my saboteurs? On their way. These guys, shouldn't they be immune to Tiberium exposure? Look at their suits. They also have these. What is this anyway? Well, doesn't really matter. I'm just going to spam. Let's actually spam some of these Nod bikes as well, because you never know when you're going to need those. They're actually really fragile, probably not going to last long against anything steel talons have, but a couple of them might be useful. Because I'm not quite sure they have hammerheads in their base, because if they do, then I'm going to need some anti-air, because those hammerheads, they're never going to land. They've got unlimited ammo, breaking several laws of thermodynamics, but that's a video game, so who cares about that. Anyway, you can get to this bike. I hope there's no units in the way. Actually, we can probably scout that. No need to risk a saboteur for that. And you just continue spamming stuff. Yeah, let's increase this again. We are going to need a lot of stuff. I'm not... The army I'm building, it looks a little bit ridiculous, but it's actually not. The base is pretty difficult to take down, especially if you don't have avatars or artillery. Or really anything that's genuinely useful. I could actually put some guys into these buildings here. So let's get the Tiberium infusion upgrade here. I can help. And here we go. The scorpion's ready. That should do us some good. And let's get an emissary. Training. As well as no scorpion tank. Yeah, I could actually get some dudes in there. Insufficient funds. The oppressors must die. Move it. So you get up here. I'm pretty sure I can't step on my own minefields, or my units will just automatically avoid it. Something like that. The scorpion's ready.
Upgrade complete.
Yeah, and it seems like the steel talons aren't really interested in attacking me. But hey, I'm not going to complain. So where's that emissary? Is that actually it's not finished yet because I'm low on money. So never mind that then. And let's get some guys in here. Because you never know, they might actually come down there eventually. So that's said, let's get one more militia squad and four rocket squads. Is the emissary ready yet? Almost. Almost. Come on. Of course, now my field here is depleted. But that's okay. We're going to get...
Enemy units sighted.
Where? Oh. Oh, now they're going to get in here. That's not good because yeah, you need to get in there right now. Because these guys are better against buildings than my guys. So yeah, but reinforcements are on the way. So where's emissary? Yeah. So you get over here. Yeah, that's what I wanted. So this should do it. Oh, looks like, well, now all the buildings here are dead. Well, okay, that's one way to do it. So come on, just shoot them. And that's a slingshot. Luckily, as I already said, can't attack any ground units, so let's just take it out. Oh, you think you're crafty? No. Forget it, I'm just going to blow that up straight away. I'm going to blow that up straight away. And hey, what do you think you're doing?
Unit under attack.
That's my spike. I need that.
Intelligence data updated.
So don't destroy that. I need that spike. So, you guys stay here. Looks like it's war now. Nope, can't enter that anymore. So let's just hang out here. And looks like I could actually save my spike here. Not bad. Yeah, I definitely triggered them now. But that's okay. You guys move up here. Should probably build more. Actually, where's my emissary? Didn't I tell this to... Oh, was that destroyed? Actually, these guys are a match for the Scorpion. Which is why I have to squish them. Actually, no, that's not what I want to do. So you guys can still blow up these guys here. These guys are just standing around there. Pretty sure they're scripted to occupy those buildings, but they can't because the buildings are no longer occupiable. So, and where's my emissary? I'm pretty sure I sent that over there. Was it just destroyed somewhere? On the what the hell are you think you're doing? Get over here.
Silos needed.
So, oh, now need silos. Yeah, I'm not going to need silos soon. Yeah, that was stupid, which is why you died. So, you guys should probably not engage these guys so close to the base, because that could actually mean that... Yeah, let's get these guys down here. Okay, so those guys stay there, that's good. So... That's sad. Let's get you placed here.
Cannot deploy here.
Okay, you stay here because you're almost dead.
Unit under attack.
And looks like there's more guys here, but that's okay. And didn't I kill you guys? I guess I didn't. So, you get over here again, and I'm going to scout with you guys because it seems these tracks just appeared out of nowhere. It seems like something destroyed my other emissary. Probably just ran to the guys who were trying to destroy my beautiful Tiberium spike. So it looks like these guys are at it now. Man, that's a lot of rock guys. I'm not gonna lie here.
You will not be overpowered.
So, there we go.
We got this handled. Let's get out there.
Do you really? Do you really?
What's the plan?
So, you, but for example, this, what were you guys thinking you're doing? You shouldn't have been there in the first place. Well, anyway, you just unfold yourself.
Silos needed.
And I don't need... So someone interrupted this. Well, I don't need silos, I need even more of these guys here.
This bike's ready.
And I probably need to get you guys over here.
Beautiful glow.
So here we go. Then I'm going to establish another refinery over there. And then I'm going to attack the base. I might actually fail doing so. But at least... Oh, here we go. At least I should be able to do some permanent damage, I hope. So, you're still harvesting here. We should actually join these guys here. We can harvest here. That should give me some decent income too. So, here you go, you join this impressive-ish army. Then let's move out, and wow. Let's just see how well we do if you just attack these guys head on. We don't do well. Let's not even try it. We have to move in here. Otherwise this isn't going to go anywhere. So, let's just squish all of them. And of course there's been more rocket guys straight away. So, let's take out their base defenses. And they have, yeah, this is not a juggernaut, this is a behemoth, this is a super juggernaut. So, and this guy does actually deal some pretty decent damage. He also deals splash damage, well, these are combat engineers by the way. The guy also deals splash damage, this is horrific. So, just try to take out that guy, because that guy is dealing way too much damage. Yeah, that sort of worked, I guess. Let's see whether I can take out the construction yard. I don't think I can, but we may as well give it a shot. Wow, I lost a ridiculous amount of stuff here in a very short amount of time. So, you harvest here. Well, that was horrific. I pretty much didn't do any damage to them. I destroyed their behemoth, but still, holy hell. I mean, I know this wasn't easy, but that was ridiculous. Well, that said, at least got some pretty decent income here again. So, yeah, we should be able to rebuild our base here in a decent amount of time. Yeah, I really wish I would have managed to destroy this, but hey, next time this will go a lot better, I think. But for now, let's just rebuild our army. Any more spikes you can take over? I don't think so. Yeah, there's one here, but there's... Oh! Are they going to come after me? I think they are. Yeah, there's another spike there, but it should be guarded by units, so there's no real point. Oh, and they're here again. There they go again, so... So at least these guys are easy to take out. And those other guys have to be squished again. So, I will hit them hard, no worries. I mean, the problem is with the bikes, they're just so fragile. They don't last. They don't last a second against anything they have here. I think I might try to take those over. First, let me take out this guard tower here. And whatever stuff they have here. Maybe I can at least... I think I should have attacked from this position here. That would have been a lot easier. And look, they even have like an old gate here. Oh, that's so nostalgic. So that said, let's get one of these guys. And maybe retreat. Yeah, definitely retreat. And let's get you guys to join those guys. Yeah, I'm going to take over the spikes here. These spikes. And didn't I... Oh, am I sending this guy up here? Oh yeah, I didn't never change that. That gathering point, which is probably something I should have done. Well, anyway.
Need help with anything?
Yes, I need help with taking over these spikes here. Because it's not only that I want those spikes, it's also that I don't want them to have those spikes. So fly. What? Yeah, there we go again. So. Oh, it's only two rocket guys this time. Which is like one squad, so. That shouldn't be too much of a problem. But nevertheless, I'm not going to risk it. So let's have you guys fly over here. And have you guys join those guys first. And then we can maybe attack them again. I actually think the first assault wasn't as bad as failure as I thought. Because I did take out some of these defenses here. And I did take out their behemoth, which is really strong. I mean, that you saw how that took out my tank cluster. That was actually a lot worse than I expected it to be. So, you guys gather here. And you guys get over here and lance. And lance. Oh yeah, here. Should probably tell you where to land. So, here we go. Let's actually take out their barracks. And then let's take out the space defense here, as well as their guns, which they don't really seem to be rebuilding, which is great. Their Titan, their other Titan, as well as their other guard tower. And these guys, this guy here, and then let's take out the construction material. We should be able to pull off. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, this time this goes a lot better. They have less stuff in their base, that's essentially enough to make a difference. Their arms factories, and once those two are down, they're essentially done. You're not going to bother with the behemoth here. So, and let's build more of these guys. Yep, we pretty much got this now. It looks like the first attack wasn't as much of a waste as I thought. I probably should have avoided trying to take out their construction yard and just take out more of their base defenses, but hey. By the way, you can't take over this base. If you take an engineer and try to capture any of the buildings will blow up. And the engineer will be killed by the infantry that comes out of it. And look how many heroic slingshots they have here and how much anti-air. They really don't want you to get any air units even near this base here. So I'm just going to take out these refineries here. I'm not going to bother with actually destroying the entire base, it's just not worth it. But these slingshots, they are easy experience, so we may as well take them out. And here's a nice army. I'm going to take that to take over the research lab. And then we should be good. Okay. So that's it. You guys get down here for repairs, and you guys get over here to take over this facility here. And I'm that was a really bad idea. That was a really bad idea. How about you do not go that way? Because there's too many rocket guys. Wait, those guys just got they got squished, poor bastards. So that's set and done. You get down here. And I'm going to build some more engineers or saboteurs or whatever, because we're going to need them. So you gather here. Let's gather you here first before I even attack. Let's build a couple more of those. And here we go. Yes, let's take this helpless AA battery on. Oh, it looks like, oh yeah, these defenses are now out of power. Oh, no, they're totally not out of power. I think that they're those magical base defenses that just don't need power. Hey, what do you think you're doing? I think they were only activated once I came close. Because it seems like it never attacked my harvester first, so. You please die, so do you. And you. And then you. Oh, and there's another behemoth. Yeah, that behemoth is actually a priority target, so let's make it that.
On the move. We are going
And yeah, but they don't really stand a chance once you're close up to them. They're really only good as ranged units. So there we go. Let's take you out. And you. So, meanwhile, at my base, I'll transport these engineers over here. And why did... Oh. Looks like these no longer land in ridiculous clusters, but actually in a place where it makes sense. So, you guys gather here. You guys gather here. And the new guys, you gather here as well. Then we should be good. So there's some random bikes. Well, guys can get over here as well. And here are my carryalls. So yeah, what happens if you take over this lab is that it will be attacked, which is why I took out this base. You don't really need to take out that base, but I just felt like doing it anyway. So I did it. Wait, why didn't... There, here we go. Oh, yeah. I always confuse those commands. So can you please... Here we go. Yeah, just do it like this. You take over this behemoth. May as well do it while we're at it. And I don't really need that spike, but I'm going to take it over anyway because I have spare engineers. So let's do that too. And you get in here.
Unit recovered.
There we go.
Objective complete.
How about some action?
Incoming transmission. Protect the lab until all data is uploaded to the Brotherhood's central servers.
Yeah, that lab looks about as futuristic as it gets. Not actually like an actual lab. So,
if more than 50% damaged, data may be corrupted. Defend it. New bonus objective.
Will do. Okay, why didn't that take me to the lab instead to the menu? Well, never mind. Anyway, there will be off-map reinforcements. Yeah, these guys are just pop out of nowhere. They aren't really producing that base, just in case you were wondering where they actually come from. But it doesn't really matter. They don't send a whole lot of stuff. They send more stuff if the base is actually standing, but it's not. So no need to worry about that. Whoa, did I call for trans all these guys? Well, that must have been expensive. I think I actually did that, so may as well transport them over here. That looks pretty ridiculous. That must have been expensive. Well, and let them all land here. This looks ridiculous. This looks very ridiculous. But I kind of like it. How expensive call for transport for these guys? 200, as usual. So, yeah, I guess that was a massive waste of time. But hey, who cares? I guess you could use this to maybe distract the enemy. The enemy's air units. But then again, if you have so many resources, you may as well just build more air units of your own. And, oh, it's just these guys. Never mind then. And... not even going to target those guys. But hey. So let's build more of these guys. Just build a bunch of MCVs because I can. And here's more off-map reinforcements. And it's just single titan, so it's not going to last long. I have the feeling these countdowns, they seem to take really long. I know, looking at it, I know it's not true, but they seem to take way longer than an actual, like a real-world clock would take. But no, I'm just imagining that. Anyway, let's just see what range you have. So, how close you have to get. Let's have a shoot over here. Let's just see. That's actually pretty decent. I don't think this guy actually shoots further. I think he's just a little stronger. And can we send in a pilot there? It seems like it. Yeah, some units can do that. Not you. What's happening here? Oh, looks like they just put a Wolverine here for no reason. That's pretty cute. Even though this guy is not really going to do anything, except for destroying my carryall. So please destroy this Wolverine instead. So let's just see whether this guy here can just transport somebody. Whether that actually has an effect. There's a couple of units where you can do that. You put in another unit and it will be beneficial. Like putting an engineer into another unit.
We got this
You got almost destroyed. And send another unit, and if you send an engineer, the engineer will repair it, or you get anti-air capabilities by putting on rocket guys, stuff like that. But anyway, did they... Oh, there's another one here. Well, looks like the map is clear now, so let's just wait the last 30 seconds. My harvesters are just standing around here. And I'm essentially wasting resources by building extra MCVs, which I don't really need. But hey, if you have that much money, may as well do it. So anything I'm building here, not really. Yeah, let's build some additional harvesters. And I'm really running out of stuff to sell, but it's only 10 seconds left, so I don't really have to worry about that. Yeah, these bases, they look very nostalgic, they're pretty old. These walls here and these guard towers, even though those are actually in one of the earlier GDI missions from Tiberium Wars. But anyway, let's see what Kane has to say.
Intelligence data updated. Establishing video uplink.
We cannot withstand this Steel Talons onslaught for long. Arrogant their commander may be, but even with his aging weapons, he has us outgunned. Disengage, my child, before all our hard-earned gains are lost. We shall return.
What onslaught do you mean? I mean, we literally took over the entire area. But hey, I guess story-wise, maybe there's like 1,000 titans waiting for us behind the borders of the map. That took actually a considerable amount of time. I guess I could have done it faster by not destroying their base, but I felt like doing it. And I think we got all the... Well, that's a lot of intel. Okay, thanks for watching. And I shall see you next time when we actually... Yeah, I think we're going back to the Outback. So take care and goodbye.